Copilot costs money, and any investment should give returns. The question is, the money is tangible, you can count it, but the benefits you get may not be tangible. It's difficult to quantify. How do you go about assessing the cost benefit? Let me show you how. Let's create a calculator. It's not complex, it's a simple Excel file. So in this Excel file, the first column is the benefit. Now let's take an example of a benefit. This is Microsoft 365 Copilot. I'm going to use it to summarize my emails. Why? Because that's the first thing you do whenever you start your day. Now, usually we'll just read the mails from top to bottom, but there could be three related mails which are scattered somewhere. You're not going to notice that upfront. It wastes a lot of time and energy. Instead of that, let's ask Copilot to do it. So this is Microsoft 365 Copilot chat. I'm asking it, summarize all my communication, and I'm giving it a specific topic about Copilot, and I'm also giving it a specific timeline this week, and today is Thursday. And then let it do its magic, and it's giving me a concise list about what I had asked for. Of course it is time saving, but look at the list. Now I read through it, and then I decide what to do. If I decide to reply to something, I don't have to go searching for Outlook or Teams. You see that citation or number there? I click on it, it opens the relevant mail, chat or whatever it is, and I can respond immediately. It will improve my prioritization, the responses, the communication quality, and overall execution. Now that is actually more important to me than time saving. But that's intangible. So now I'm going to say time saving this much and the intangible portion converted to time notional value is this much. Okay. Now the next thing you have to think of is I benefited from it. How many other people in my organization will benefit from it? Let's say for argument's sake 500. And then you have to think, is it going to be done every day, 5 times a day, frequency? So in this case, I'm going to say it's going to happen every day, at least once, and we have 18 working days. Now, you multiply these and you get a number of total time saving across the organization for this particular benefit. Like this, you keep adding more benefits. Let's take another example. Here, I have a job description for a role. Then I got some CVs or resumes. There's one resume, there's another one, like that I have many. Now as a recruiter, I need to look at the JD requirements and correlate that with the resumes I receive and then choose the best candidate. So how can Copilot help me here? Well, I go to Copilot chat and now I'm asking it to compare them and give me a tabulation. Something a recruiter does all the time. And look at the results it has given me. It's amazing. Is it time saving? Yes, of course. So I'll put that number. But in this case, the drudgery of comparing this manually is gone completely. I get more accurate results faster. So less effort, more impact. So in this case, the intangible value is much more. Now, is this going to affect all users? No. I have only few recruiters, so I put that number. And are they doing it every day? No. So I put that number and then I get the calculation. So now tabulate benefits by applying Copilot features to different people and different business requirements. And then you will have a long list and a very big number. But now that number is just time saving in minutes. Now let's convert it to hours by dividing by 60, again convert it to days by dividing by 8. So now this is the total time saving per month across the organization. But still, it is time. I want to convert it to money. How do I do that? Well, there are multiple ways. One method is to just take employee cost, so average salary, and say what is the daily salary and figure out. The other method is take the total turnover or profit or whatever you want, and then divide it by number of employees and find out per employee contribution. And of course, there must be many other more sophisticated ways of converting this intangible thing into money terms. Now you know the cost, which is whatever the cost of Copilot is. As of today, it is $30 per user per month. But more importantly, you know the benefit out of it. And now you can take an informed decision. Most of this ROI justification, cost benefit analysis dies when the purchase is done. Because after the purchase is done, who is responsible for going through each line item and making sure I put a number of 500 here or 50 or whatever? Those 50 people, do they know about it? Are they going to use it? Despite having licenses, nobody went and told them that this is what you're doing now and this is what you should be doing, because we bought a new thing for you, a better thing for you. So the same list, which was just a cost justification Excel sheet earlier, now becomes the adoption driver. And who is going to do it? Not L&D, not IT. The person who signed the check, basically the leadership, has to take the onus, because if you are spending money, you have to be responsible for making sure that money is fully utilized. If you leave it to someone else, that's not going to happen. Did you find this sensible, practical, and useful? Then share it with as many people as you can. Try it out yourself and let me know the impact. If you want to become more efficient every day, subscribe to this channel. And if you have any queries or you have ideas for me to create more videos, do let me know. So that's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.